Hey guys, welcome to Meterics. Today we'll be having a look at the smart sensor digital sound level meter. This is the AS824 model. So this is a type 2 digital sound level meter, meaning that it has both A and C waiting frequencies on it. So it's a pretty easy and standard meter to use. So what we're going to do is we'll pop the batteries in. This uses a 9 volt battery, put that in the back, and then we turn the meter on. So we push this button once, and in a matter of seconds you will see it has an analog bar and some values up there. Now these are the values of the sound level readings that it's currently picking up. We'll go through the buttons, which is quite easy. We have up here, we have a plus and a minus, which say level on them. Now what these do is they give you the option to choose what range you would like on the analog bar up top. Currently it says 30 and 110. If we push that there, we get 30 to 100, you push that again, 50 to 100. So it basically gives you a couple of ranges for you to choose from. If you don't know which range to use and you're not sure, all you need to do is turn the meter off and turn it on. Then it will automatically choose a range for you once it's starting up, basing on what sound levels that it's picking up. Next to here, we have the A and C button. What these do is they give you the option of choosing what frequency you're using. Currently we are on A, so we can see we have a dBA indicator here. And if we push that, we get to C. So it just lets you know that we're now dealing with the C frequencies. This button here basically says light, and it just does what it says, which provides a backlight. Gives you a green, bright backlight, so it's easy to see and easy to use in a dark environment. You push it again and the backlight goes off. Alongside that, we have the max and min button. Now what this does, once pushed, we'll have, it says here, hold max. Now what this will do is it will retain the highest value that it picks up. And if we push it again, it goes to hold min. Now this will retain the lowest value that it gets to pick. So if I am quieter, the volumes drop and it will show the least value that it detects. Push that again, we're out of the mode and we're still now in just random spontaneous measurements. We have an F and S here. What these do is they alter the resolution of the meter. So we have F for fast, like you can see now, and fast, basically the resolution is 125 milliseconds. If we push this to slow, it slows the resolution down to a second. So that's it. Those are all the buttons and what they do. That's pretty much how to use the meter. Once you're done, just don't forget to push this button to turn it off. And there you go. Hope to see you again next time.